Hello, today we're going to be looking at drawing daffodils. There's plenty of them around at this time of year, so it's a good subject to practice your drawing skills with. See, I've got a little bit of tissue at the end of that one there. Just be careful with daffodils. The sap that comes out of them when you cut them at the end, if you get that on your skin and then you touch your face or anything like that, you can get a little bit of a nasty rash from that, so just be careful. And that's also the same reason why it's not a good idea to put daffodils in the same vase as other flowers, because that sap that comes out of your daffodil will kill the other flowers that are in the vase. So nothing to do with that, but just a little tip for you. Okay, so it's basically, this part's a trumpet shape here, and then these petals would more or less fit into a circle. So if you look back at the last flower demonstration that I did about drawing, which I'll put the link up here to that one, you'll see we talked about getting those basic shapes in. So really, we're going to start with three circles. We've got the circle that goes around where the petals are, another circle here, and this circle at the base of this trumpet, to get that 3D shape of the trumpet. Now, I've got a full vase of them here, but actually they're not coming out too quickly because it's quite cool in the studio. But I'll pop that one back in the vase with the others and I'll work from that one that I've just showed you to begin with. I'm just going to pop it on an angle. I don't know if you can hear, there was a plane just went past outside. It's usually nice and quiet here, but you might have just been able to hear that plane. Okay, so I've popped that on an angle, and I'm going to start with that big circle for the petals that are behind, and it's now on an angle, so we're drawing an ellipse. And again, I talked about these ellipses in the video I did on drawing a wine glass, so again I'll pop that one in the corner as well, just to similar, although it's a completely different subject, similar techniques. Now if I look at the end of the trumpet, the open end, that's actually coming out a little bit because I've got this daffodil on an angle now, a little bit past here, so that's actually there. And look at the size of that circle in comparison to the size of the circle we had before. Don't worry about all these lines, we can rub some of those out. This is just to work to, and it's to get your arm moving and to get a feel for the shape of this daffodil. Now, the angle that is at the end of the trumpet is actually quite low down here, because this petal here is foreshortened. It's towards us, whereas the others are further back because of the angle that it's at. So you get your daffodil in front of you and work to the one you've got. I will take some photographs of these as well, and so that you can see what I've drawn them from. Okay, so the easiest thing to begin with now is we've got, that's the end of the trumpet, the open end and the petals. So to begin with, we'll pop the sides of the trumpet in so we know where it is. Okay? And then we'll go and start putting the petals in so that I can just about see the one that's behind here, and it comes to a nice point. So we are breaking that line. In fact, I've broken it too much, that's coming up too far. I'll just look back, it's about here somewhere. And then it joins the base of the flower around here. And it comes to quite a nice point there. And then we'll go around, look at the next one. In fact, I'll do this one because the next one is behind. So I'll do the ones that are in front first. And like I said before, that's foreshortened and it comes just to about there. You just draw what you can see. Don't go inventing anything. Draw the lines that you can see. And we can rub that bit out that's just a guideline there. Okay. Might look a bit silly now because we've not got the shading in to show us that that one's going forward. But that will all come in the end. I've got that line. So they're basically fitting into that circle, although the edges of the petals are breaking out over the edge. So that one we can see is behind, and it's actually bending a little bit like that. So it's just going to give us a feel for the direction that that petals going. And then this one here comes from about the rim somewhere, and it's quite a long petal. So just concentrate on the petals one at a time, look carefully. It's an observational drawing. You need to keep looking back at the flower and keep thinking about where those lines are going. Okay, so now that we've got the basics in, we can rub out some of those unneeded lines. So I'm hoping this shows up on the camera. So there we go, from that, those three circles, one, two, three, you've got your basic daffodil shape. Now when it comes to doing the stem, don't start and draw your stem stuck onto a petal, stuck onto the outside of the flower. The stem is attached here at the back of the plant. So even though we can't see that because it's behind, move with your hand along so it will look more natural. It's actually got that very papery, I don't really know what you call it, but it's like a papery covering peeping up there and around the stem. And that shape. Okay, now if we look back at the flower, the end of the trumpet was very, if you can remember from when I showed you it, it was very raggedy, if that's a word. So we're just going to get those shapes in. Don't worry about every single little curve around this edge being just as it is on the flower, you'll drive yourself mad. Just get that feel for those petals going down. And of course the side that's nearest to you, you can see the back of, and then this goes down into the trumpet. So we're now making it look like it's a little cup. We've got these lines going down into the inside of the trumpet, and this is the back side of the trumpet. And then we can get rid of those guidelines. And this is actually tapering in more and then coming out. So at this stage, this is where you can start and tighten things up, be a bit more observant of the shapes that we've got there. And at the base here, it sort of joins along every petal in more of a line than, you know, it's not just circular, it's more of a sort of hexagon. And that's just made me think, there is six petals, and what, I've missed one of them. One of them you can only just see, but it is there at the back. And we've also got some lines going down there. So this part you won't be able to see at all, because that's behind and this is solid. So that's the inside and then we've got the outside. And I think actually, as far as the pencil goes, that's enough detail for now. We'll go on to putting some colour onto it. So, before I do that, just to talk actually through some of these buds. So you're going to be quite different. It'd be nice if you're doing a full painting to pop some buds in as well. And you can see that's quite a simple shape. This, what I was calling the papery bit at the back, and you can hear it's quite crinkly, quite papery. Just one shape there. And then this very simple shape here with the two petals there overlapping. So it'd be nice, you know, pop some of those different shapes in the back and all that, you can see just ready to come out. So just a nice touch of colour, and do one or two at different stages. Try a few. One a little bit more open or one completely in bud. But we're just going to stick to this one for today. Okay, so some yellow, some nice bright yellow. It was very sunny outside, but it's just disappeared again now. So these are some of the watercolour pencils. I just can't remember which ones I've picked up. Oh, it's the Faber Castell ones. Just getting a bit more of a point on the end of that there. They're quite soft, so it's not easy to get them in the point. You'll notice, you've probably seen on other videos, you won't have seen me using a pencil sharpener. I always use a knife. Much better for your pencils, I think, than a pencil sharpener. Okay, so we need to think about where the tones are. So look very carefully at where the shadows are and look very carefully at where the light's hitting. To set off with, I'm going to more or less do it yellow all over and then pop some darker tones in. Go darker as we go along, but leave some highlights as well where the light's hitting most of all. So the light's hitting right on the edge of these petals. So I will leave one or two bits of white. Try and get a nice crisp edge to that petal. Leave one or two bits of white showing. So what I want to do now is go around the whole thing. As I'm drawing, I'm going to draw in the direction of the growth, and I'm going to leave one or two bits of white for highlights, but I will speed this little part of the video up for you so you don't have to sit and watch me doing all of it. Okay, so now I've got the whole flower yellow. I'm going to start and put some shadows in. So look where the petals are casting shadows on themselves, where the trumpet's casting shadows on the petals, and you know where the petals are curled slightly, they're casting shadows as well. And as you could see when I was doing that, I was always going in the direction that the petals were going, moving my arm around in the direction that the petals are going, and that will give you a much more convincing look. So to begin with, we've got quite a few shadows going on where these little bits at the edges are curled over, and of course the inside of the trumpet where we're not getting as much light to the inside there. And if you look carefully, you'll see that that's quite dark in there where it's going down inside the trumpet. So that all wants colouring in. There's no light hitting the inside there, and that will make this front side of the daffodil stand out more if we get it nice and dark behind. So plenty of green over this, and we're going to put some water over this and blend it all together once we've finished. So just getting things generally in the direction that they're going, and then we're going to finish off with a little bit of water because these are water soluble pencils. And I will put a link to some watercolour pencils in the description below if you're interested. If you've not got any and want to have a look at them, they're rather nice to have. They're nice to take on holiday, things like that. They're good for travelling with when you don't want to take your full paint set with you. And so like I said before, don't worry about every single little shadow or line, because they're very, very complicated. We're just getting a feel. It's just a little beginner's exercise. So just look at the general shapes where the general shadows are and keep your arm moving in that direction of the growth. Okay, so we've got that green there. I'm using green because if you look at the flower, it's picking up reflections of the green from the stems and the leaves, but also there is a tinge of green still in that flower, especially down at the base here where it's all joined together. So we'll just put some. I'm not going to worry too much about drawing the stem in, but I will just pop some green in to be going on with. This is actually more brown, but I will just be starting to colour that shape in. Now if I look here, this petal slightly curved over at the top, so it's casting a shadow on itself there where it's curving. And then again, one or two lines where it's folding round, but actually a lot of that's in the light, so not too much on there. This one is casting a shadow on this one, so here And also it's curling over on this edge, so we've got quite a shadow there, all down this side of this petal and into the base. And again, one or two lines. This petal here, because it's angled slightly upwards, is casting a shadow onto the base of the trumpet, which has also got shadow around here as well. This is semi-transparent, so it's quite difficult to get that feel. It's a bit like painting glass, so it's try and keep it as simple as we can, really. So it's nice and dark around the base there, obviously, where no light's getting to it at all, really. And then this one, some shadows, and it's curling around on itself again there as well. So just look how they're curled, how they're angled. This one hasn't got much light at all because it's underneath this one, and it's the trumpets causing the light from above to not hit that either. So this has got quite a lot of shadow. So you can see what I'm doing, just thinking about one petal at a time, thinking about where the light's hitting and where the light can't hit, and moving that pencil around. Okay, so this one, this side is very much in shade because of the curve of the petal, and this side not so much. Again, that trumpet's causing this side to be in the shade. And then behind, this one's sort of just curling off in the distance, so there isn't much we can see of that one, really. Now my next pencil, I'm going to choose, this is another green, but it's quite a bluey green. And that's going to make us even darker shadows. So now look very carefully at the flower, squint your eyes slightly, and decide where your absolute darkest areas are. So for me, the behind here, this is very dark. Down this side of the stem. And in here. Again, like I said, this shadow that the trumpet's causing on these petals here is about the darkest area of the flower. So, and again, one or two spots here where it's curling over, and that's going into the centre. Quite dark, and it's also quite dark along this edge here. But take it out into the petal so we can see the direction of the growth. And finally, this bit up here. Okay, and then just to brighten it up a bit, I'm going to put a little bit of orange in there as well. It's not too orangey, but some daffodils are, and I think it's just going to warm it up a bit. And of course we can use some artistic license, we don't have to do it just as it is. So just in areas, because don't forget this is all going to mix together with the paint, with the water. Just in one or two areas, I'm going to add a little bit of orange, just to warm that yellow up. But still going in the direction of the growth of the flower. And one thing I have forgotten is to put that papery bit on the stem and think about the colour of that. That's sort of a browny colour, isn't it? So let's have a look. See what we've got. Something like that will probably do it. It's a beigey colour. Like the flowers, it's still got these lines. Okay, so now I've got that amount of colour on, we're not finished, but we're going to get a brush. I haven't got a brush. One moment. Okay, sorry about that. I didn't have my brush ready. So it's quite a smallish brush. I'm just seeing if the number's written on. It's a number 3 round, and it's a sable one, is this. So quite small, because I want to get into the corners, into the edges here. Don't forget, you can leave some white edges as well, and leave some little areas of white. So there, perhaps just leave a little splash of white here and there where you've not put any water, just to give us that idea of one or two highlights. But paint in the direction of the growth again. I know we keep saying this, but it just makes it so much easier and it looks so much more convincing. Okay, and bring those right down to that frilly little edge. And how much you blend these colours together sort of depends on you and the effect that you like to achieve. I think that's probably enough for me. Again, leave one or two bits of white just to show where the light's bouncing off. You can see what I mean about getting into the corners with this little brush. It's a nice shape to get into those corners. So we'll start at the top, then we're not dragging our hands across bits we've already done. And really, this is the fun part, putting the water on after you've done all that drawing. So good way to get an introduction into painting if you're new to it all, if you're a beginner. I should say that this paper is a watercolour paper. Again, I'll put a link to the materials that I've used in the description below, just so that you know which ones I've used. Coming on to this leaf, or it's not really a leaf, is it? It's the casing that's sort of been left behind that was protecting the flower whilst it was a bud. Leave that little bit of white there because there's a little rim around. Okay, so hopefully that's given you a little drawing introduction into flowers. Like I say, I've done another couple of videos that you might want to have a look at that could help you with this. One was the wine glass and the other one drawing roses. Basically just getting a feel for drawing those ellipses that we talked about earlier. I'm going to carry on now and do a background on this one, which you might like to do on yours as well. Hopefully you've got some daffodils handy that you can have a go at. Just think of it as an observational drawing. Keep looking at where the shades, shadows, tones are, and just enjoy yourself, really. I'll put a list below in the description to all the materials that I've used. If you've any comments, I'd love to hear from you. And if you've any suggestions of other drawing tutorials that you would like, please let me know. Okay, so thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. Bye for now.